Peter Goldman, appearing for the plaintiff, Your Honor.
Gavin Q. Baker and City Attorney Lee for the defense, Your Honor.
I have read the defense's motion for summary judgment and the papers filed in opposition. I think there very well might be some triable issues of material fact.
Yes, Your Honor. I ask you to look at page 6 of Mr. Goldman's pleading, where he states, Terrell Baylor was murdered by person or persons unknown. Defense regards this as an admission against interest. If counsel has no idea who killed Mr. Baylor, how do we proceed?
Your Honor, Deputy Chief Johnson abandoned Terrell Baylor in gang territory where his fellow Crips were massing to execute him.
Excuse me, Your Honor. Chief Johnson dropped Mr. Baylor off at his house where he requested to go. It's not the defendant's fault that Mr. Baylor lived in gang territory.
Your Honor, everyone knows Terrell Baylor was murdered by members of his own gang.
Your Honor, if everyone knows this, why has counsel submitted no evidence substantiating this fact? Instead, he asked the court to try his opinion, an improper use of the justice system, even if one were to accept that in this instance, the Warren Rule did not apply.
The Warren Rule would only apply if Chief Johnson had been negligent. She wasn't negligent. She actively facilitated the murder of Terrell Baylor. And this motion for summary judgment is a feeble excuse to get that charge to just go away.
I congratulate counsel on so swiftly divining both our objective and the definition of a summary judgment, which is to immediately terminate these proceedings in favor of the defendants and to make these baseless charges, as he puts it, just go away.
I notice defendants aren't even waiting for Your Honor's ruling to go away.
Your Honor, I am saddened to announce that just moments ago, a deputy sheriff was shot and killed. I hope Your Honor is not offended, understanding that police officers are oftentimes required to put public safety ahead of personal interest.
Anything further, Mr. Goldman?